Well, I think that a lot of the things that we've been talking about have influenced the younger generation of the last, say, 20 years. The books, the combination of practice and theory, the interest and and I think attitude, you know, when I was in architecture school, for the most part, and most of the people I know, you know, when you graduated, you went into architecture. For many young people today, they either stay in school or teach, and a lot of people stay sort of in academia, as it were, for a longer period of time, and therefore, are not as much in a rush to go into practice, and are also looking at other areas in which they can work as an architect rather than traditional practice. So I think that sort of, in a sense, affects the young people. And I think that all of the influences, you know, from both the schools and the publications influenced sort of the work that's being done by young architects. And sort of the blip that we talked about that occurred in the 80s, you know, they don't even know about it. I mean, it's like it doesn't exist. You know, it's not part of their educational experience. I mean, it's sort of like what's happening now is more of an influence on them.
However, you know, a lot of the teachers grew up during that period, yeah. Unfortunately, and they have an influence today in that lack of, lack of direction.
Yeah. I only know the places where I've gone to lecture and seen the work. Someone in the office just did a slide show of what she was teaching when she was at the University of Florida. You know, it was terrific abstract exercises and making of space and you know, very, very good. So I don't see where she was influenced, at least by